great to use in purposes like this. So we brought out a VT-100, which is a robot with a PTZ camera on it, 1080p readout. It can be configured in many different forms. Today we're using tracks just because we're navigating over different types of terrain.
As we all know, over 98% of our planet is covered by the waters of the Earth, and it's no wonder that as we delve deeper into these enigmatic depths, we continue to uncover some truly strange and remarkable discoveries. In a recent podcast, the renowned Joe Rogan revealed that the Navy, in collaboration with leading marine scientists, has stumbled upon a terrifying and mind-boggling discovery in the ocean. What peculiarities have these deep-sea divers found? How has humanity influenced the ecosystem of the ocean? In this video, we'll reveal the story Joe Rogan told us of what the Navy saw while diving in the ocean. The vast and significant global ocean, an immense saltwater expanse, blankets more than 70% of the Earth's surface. Among these expansive waters, the Great Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, and Arctic oceans are the primary bodies meticulously classified by scientists. Recently, National Geographic officially recognized a fifth ocean, known as the Southern Ocean, on June 8, 2021, encircling the icy continent of Antarctica. In the mysterious depths of these oceans, scientists grapple with the awe-inspiring mystery of how many marine species inhabit these waters. Awe turns to amazement as we learn of the staggering number, currently, a recognized 226,000 ocean species. Yet, the wonder doesn't end there. The marine realm, a crucible of life, is undergoing challenges. Pollution, warming seas, and other environmental issues threaten many of these oceanic species, leading to a decline in their numbers. Astonishingly, scientists remain on the brink of discovering even more living wonders, estimating the potential existence of several hundred thousand to a few million yet to be identified species. What oddities are there in the ocean? Joe Rogan, the wildly humorous comedian, MMA commentator, and the host of one of the world's most phenomenally popular podcasts, has not just expressed his amazement but has marveled at the mind-boggling unknown potential dwelling in these uncharted oceanic depths, referring to the ocean as colossal and beautiful monster soup. Astonishingly, scientists, the Navy, and even the esteemed NASA appear to share this sense of wonder. Joe Rogan recently interviewed Gareth Riesman, a NASA astronaut and one of the few people to have experienced both space and the bottom of the ocean. Riesman participated in the Nemo 5 mission along with other team members from the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Agency. They lived in a habitat called Aquarius, anchored to the ocean floor, to train for life in space under space-like conditions. This experience has led NASA to explore deeper regions to study even more extreme conditions than those in space. In a groundbreaking collaboration, NASA and the Navy have joined forces with the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institute to explore the Huddle Zone trenches. Situated predominantly in the Pacific Ocean's fiery ring of fire, where colossal tectonic plates meet, these trenches carve profound gouges into the seabed. The Mariana Trench, the deepest among them, plunges nearly 7 miles below sea level, bearing the ominous name of Hades, the mythical Greek god of the underworld. In an ambitious undertaking, NASA is constructing a remotely operated vehicle named Orpheus, equipped with navigational technology akin to the Mars Perseverance rover. Its mission is to meticulously map the near-otherworldly seascape of these profound deep-sea trenches, unraveling the potential for life in these extreme depths. This endeavor echoes a past attempt 2014 when scientists from the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institute sent a vehicle named Nereus 6.2 miles down into the Challenger Deep near New Zealand, only to witness its catastrophic demise due to the overwhelming pressure. The crushing pressure at these staggering depths is of such intensity that it can squeeze the life out of creatures ill-equipped for such an environment. Until 1977, scientists were convinced that life couldn't endure such conditions. Yet, when a team of brave U.S. scientists submerged the vehicle named Alvin into the Pacific Ocean to study hydrothermal vents, they were astounded to discover a thriving ecosystem around the deep-sea volcanoes. Remarkable creatures such as translucent snailfish and minuscule crustaceans were not merely surviving but flourishing. Further investigation revealed these extraordinary organisms possessed special enzymes and piezolites, which supported their cell membranes and prevented them from succumbing to extreme pressures. This groundbreaking discovery sparked a widely embraced theory that life on Earth might have originated around these hydrothermal vents, where creatures eschew sunlight and exist on the chemical concoction emanating from the seafloor. Exploring the oceanic depths has always unveiled submerged secrets, including the ancient marvel of Pavla Petri, a 5,000-year-old Greek city thought to have been entombed around 1000 BC. However, crafting a vehicle capable of withstanding the intense pressure at 40 miles down is an audacious undertaking that engineers grapple with. They are facing the challenge of creating a vessel that can endure pressures 6 miles down and prevent a recurrence of the mishap in Nereus in 2014 as it explored the oceans. These oceans, teeming with life and mysteries, serve as a source of knowledge, revealing the evolution of the ocean over the past few decades. From the colossal prehistoric megalodon, the largest shark ever to exist, to the resilient contemporary tube worms thriving in the harsh conditions of the deep sea, the oceanic depths continue to astound and captivate with their remarkable tales of life's evolution. The breathtaking Arctic Ocean, enveloping the frigid Arctic region, stands as the northernmost water body on Earth. Despite its classification as the smallest ocean, spanning approximately 5.4 million square miles, it commands attention by constituting a remarkable 4% of the Earth's surface, surpassing the United States in size by 1.5 times. This ocean, characterized by its shallowness, boasts an average depth of 3,953 feet and a jaw-dropping maximum depth of 18,264 feet. This distinctive feature is primarily attributed to the region's limited evaporation rates and the substantial influx of fresh water from majestic glaciers and rivers. The Arctic Ocean, shrouded in ice for most of the year, is now grappling with the profound impacts of climate change. The once formidable extent and thickness of the Arctic sea ice have dramatically diminished in the face of escalating global temperatures, evoking a sense of urgency and environmental apprehension. This transformation has triggered concerns about the fragile Arctic ecosystem and ignited discussions about potential geopolitical tensions. Furthermore, it has fueled fascination regarding promising economic opportunities, including exploring new shipping routes and extracting untapped natural resources. In a remarkable twist, the Arctic marine ecology thrives amidst these extreme conditions, animated by the interplay of river mouths, cascading glacial ice, and dynamic ocean currents. Even beneath the icy surface, the resilient phytoplankton, the foundational force in the marine food chain, ensures the continued vitality of this extraordinary Arctic realm. These incredibly small plants not only grow but perform the astonishing feat of photosynthesis, transforming light and nutrients into intricate organic chemicals. The duration of their bloom period, the phytoplankton, hinges on the availability of sunshine and nutrients, both undergoing seasonal changes and being influenced by ice cover. Remarkably, colossal sponges were unearthed 2 years ago, thriving atop long-extinct underwater volcanoes beneath the perpetually ice-covered Arctic Ocean. Astonishingly, these Arctic sponges from the Geodia family sustain themselves by feasting on the fossilized remains of prehistoric animals, adapting to survive in nutrient-poor conditions, as per the revelations of diligent researchers. Anton Kabosius, a marine biologist affiliated with the Max Planck Institute for Marine Microbiology and the Alfred Wegener Institute in Germany, was the chief scientist on the Polar Stern icebreaker research vessel in 2016. Notably, this vessel was recently involved in the monumental discovery of massive Antarctic ice fish nests. During the Arctic expedition, the team employed camera equipment to unveil the secrets of the seafloor at Langseth Ridge, an underwater mountain range with depths ranging between 700 and 1,000 meters, situated not far from the North Pole. Their captivating photographs unveiled an underwater world teeming with extraordinary richness and densely populated habitats perched on top of long-extinct volcanoes. This revelation left scientists awestruck, as the common understanding was that sponges thrived universally in oceans, ranging from vibrant tropical reefs to icy Antarctic waters. Typically, these resilient creatures feed by skillfully filtering food from the surrounding seawater, enabling them to consume nutrient-rich particles efficiently. Surviving in the Arctic Ocean is an extraordinary challenge because this region has been encased in ice for countless years, making it a harsh environment with limited food, reaching the depths where these resilient Geoidea sponges flourish. So, how do these remarkable sponges persevere? To unveil the secrets of their longevity and feeding habits, Teresa Morganti, an expert in sponges from the Max Planck Institute for Marine Microbiology, meticulously examined captivating photographs and tissue samples. Surprisingly, these sponges harbor robust bacterial populations, boasting an astonishing average age of 300 years. Morganti's illuminating explanation states, "Our in-depth analysis revealed that these sponges have incredible microbial partners, known as symbionts, capable of utilizing aged organic matter. This unique ability allows them to feast on the remnants of once present but now extinct inhabitants of the seamounts, such as the protein and chitin-rich worm tubes and other entangled debris. Various types of sponges play host to a diverse population of microbes that transport essential nutrients from the surrounding water to the sponges, efficiently manage waste, and produce antibiotics to ensure the sponges' robust health." As demonstrated by Morganti and her colleagues' groundbreaking research, these Arctic sponges showcase an astounding ability to consume organic substances trapped in the mat on which they reside, defying conventional wisdom by not solely relying on seawater as their primary source of nutrition. The ancient biosphere still vividly persists in the resilient mat beneath the sea, preserving remnants of a rich and diverse environment from thousands of years ago. Over time, countless elements vanished, leaving behind astonishing sponge gardens that captivate with their surprising beauty and resilience. Remarkably, microscopic allies, the microbes, employ enzymes to break down fossilized remains of an ancient ecosystem. Using ancient leftovers, they skillfully transfer essential nutrients to their sponge hosts. Joe Rogan and other esteemed scientists emphasize the indispensability of such groundbreaking research as the Arctic climate undergoes rapid change, and its sea ice diminishes swiftly. This research becomes a critical quest to safeguard the extraordinary diversity thriving in the pressurized Arctic seas. On another frontier, researchers, backed by NASA, have unearthed a colossal algal bloom thriving beneath the dense Arctic ice, revolutionizing our understanding of the region's ecosystems. The analogy drawn by NASA scientists likens this biological revelation to stumbling upon a rainforest in the heart of a desert, an astonishing and paradigm-shifting discovery. Beneath the dwindling Arctic ice, the tenacious phytoplankton, those diminutive plants, exhibit unparalleled vitality. Astonishingly, the Arctic is believed to currently host a phytoplankton growth surpassing any other ocean on our planet, exposing an entirely new dimension of the Arctic's warming and reshaping environment. This revelation stands as a cornerstone for researchers, offering crucial insights into the intricate interplay of climate change and the evolving ecology of the Arctic Ocean. Scientists courageously drilled through 3 feet of sea ice in a daring quest to comprehend how environmental shifts impact Arctic life. Their findings left them in sheer amazement, discovering an incredibly active phytoplankton community, multiplying more than once daily. In contrast, open waters witnessed a more gradual growth, with these remarkable tiny plants doubling over 2 to 3 days, a breathtaking revelation that adds to the ever-expanding tapestry of Arctic marvels. The speed at which these tiny, incredible plants, known as phytoplankton, are growing is one of the highest ever seen in the Arctic Ocean. People used to think these plants only started flourishing after the ice melted in the summer, about 72 miles inside the ice. However, the researchers found that the plants were growing under the ice. Surprisingly, these vibrant plant communities didn't come from the open ocean where there are usually lots of them, but instead grew right under the ice. The discovery of these plant communities under the ice, which were not known before, significantly affects the wider Arctic environment. This includes animals that move around a lot, like whales and birds. Small sea creatures devour these incredible plants, and then bigger fish and ocean animals feast on those smaller creatures. Scientists might need to revise their ideas about how the Arctic works and fits into the Earth's system. In the daring October 2021 mission called the HACON Project, a group of over 24 brilliant scientists and engineers used an advanced underwater robot to successfully delve into a cryptic ocean world some 13,000 feet beneath the surface of the ice-covered Arctic Ocean. This groundbreaking expedition marked the first-ever exploration of rare volcanic vents and the unique life thriving in the remote Arctic. Eva Ramirez-Lodra, an esteemed deep-sea ecologist co-leading the mission, said that the mission would open a breathtaking new frontier in the Arctic. The challenge was monumental, considering scientists couldn't simply journey to the Arctic and drop a resilient exploration robot into the water. They relied on a formidable icebreaker, a thick-hulled ship, to navigate through treacherous packs of floating ice known as ice floes. Once at their remote destination, the scientists faced the constant challenge of drifting ice, providing only fleeting windows for deep-sea exploration. Undeterred by these obstacles, the exploration team successfully deployed their cutting-edge exploration robot, Aurora, to investigate the Aurora vent field. This deep-sea region, brimming with geyser-like vents called black smokers, emits hot, dark, volcanic liquid into the water. Unique life forms, including snails, worms, and crustaceans, thrive on these volcanic chemicals in a lightless world devoid of sunlight. Such active vent fields are exceedingly rare globally, and the imperative to protect them involves exploration and the meticulous sampling of the life inhabiting these areas. As nations gear up to mine the deep sea for precious metals, the urgency to safeguard these extraordinary ecosystems intensifies. The HACON mission uncovered a plethora of life around the vents, including snails, crustaceans, and shrimp, with comprehensive samples collected for further analysis. The collected samples promise to unveil whether the life surrounding these Arctic black smokers is genuinely isolated and unique or interconnected with deep-sea life in other oceans. The scientists, confident in making groundbreaking discoveries, anticipate revealing the first scientific results within 6 months. Before disclosing more discoveries that were made in the Antarctic, let's talk about how man has been able to interact and impact the ocean's ecosystem. Scientists are getting worried about the impact of plastic trash on people's health and sea life. They found a shocking amount of plastic stuck in the ice in the Arctic. In samples taken from 5 places on trips to the Arctic Ocean, they discovered up to 12,000 tiny, troublesome plastic pieces in every liter of sea ice. This is up to 3 times more than they find in the Pacific garbage patch. According to a groundbreaking study, it's staggering that at least 1 trillion pieces of plastic have frozen into the Arctic ice over recent decades. However, Dr. Gunnar Gertz, the researcher behind these measurements, uncovered a significant graver issue. Some of these plastic particles are incredibly minuscule, measuring a mere 11 micrometers, roughly 1/6 t.h. the diameter of a human hair. Beyond the Arctic Ocean, Dr. Ilka P. Ken, a key contributor to the study, sheds light on a concerning regional smog situation in the Arctic. Experts express genuine concern about the uncertain and potentially severe effects this level of plastic pollution might inflict on human health and marine life. Marine plastic pollution is an alarming and formidable challenge, with an estimated 5 trillion plastic pieces drifting in the world's oceans. The consequences of plastic debris extend to marine life, with fish and birds frequently confusing these plastic bits for food, causing harm to sea creatures and infiltrating the human food chain. Microplastics, pervasive in the ocean's surface waters, create an omnipresent challenge, leaving no haven. Shifting our attention to Antarctica, this frozen continent has captivated explorers and scientists for centuries. From the intrepid researchers of today to the renowned pioneers of the 1800s, the allure of Antarctica lies in the astonishing treasures hidden within its frozen expanses. Antarctica, shrouded in mystique as the last untouched wilderness on Earth, is adept at safeguarding its secrets, owing to the extremities of its conditions. Antarctica is deemed uninhabitable, with approximately 400 lakes buried beneath 3 kilometers of ice, a revelation uncovered by radar in 1970, further contributing to the enigma of this extraordinary landscape. Scientists reveal that the breathtaking lakes in Antarctica are the outcome of the continent's dramatic separation from the ancient supercontinent Gondwana. These extraordinary lakes defy freezing due to the immense weight of the ice sheets, creating an awe-inspiring spectacle. The colossal subglacial lake, Lake Vostok, situated 3.5 kilometers beneath the ice, not only stands as a testament to its impressive depth but also boasts air purity that has remained pristine for millions of years. In this mesmerizing underwater realm, an array of remarkable life forms, including resilient germs, colossal crabs, gigantic squid, elongated spiders reminiscent of dinner plates, and massive golden-bristled sharp-jawed worms, thrive in an environment unparalleled in its uniqueness. Transparent ice fish add a layer of wonder with their huge eyes and translucent skin, unveiling intricate internal organs. These incredible beings, equipped with antifreeze glycoproteins, showcase their remarkable survival ability in frigid waters. Adding to the fascination, these organisms harness energy from unconventional sources like methane and ammonia instead of relying on sunlight, marking a groundbreaking discovery with the potential to reshape our understanding of evolution. Researchers also discovered a captivating hidden world beneath the icy surface of the Larsen Ice Shelf, unveiling an extraordinary ecosystem teeming with thousands of tiny crustaceans known as amphipods. The underground river, concealed 1,640 feet below the Antarctic ice, revealed a mysterious and thriving habitat. A groundbreaking, detailed map of the Southern Ocean provided scientists with unprecedented views of the seafloor surrounding Antarctica, exposing its deepest point, the Kvaterian Deep. Seemingly impossible phytoplankton blooms, challenging previous assumptions, showcased a mesmerizing underwater spectacle beneath Earth's polar regions. Underwater robots captured a precarious hold of Antarctica's Thwaites Glacier, known as the Doomsday Glacier, revealing parallel grooves on the seafloor from previous rapid retreats, raising concerns about potential future rapid melting linked to climate change. The discovery of a massive underground river flowing beneath Antarctica, draining melting ice into the Weddell Sea, painted a breathtaking picture of an unseen and colossal waterway beneath the icy continent. NASA's Terra satellite documented the awe-inspiring journey of the world's largest iceberg, 76A, floating away from Antarctica. The Arctic Ocean, once regarded as pristine and untouched, is now under siege from an insidious and pervasive threat, plastic pollution. In recent years, scientists have made a startling revelation: the Arctic ice, which has long been considered a symbol of purity, is concealing a hidden menace. Microplastics, tiny fragments of plastic, have infiltrated the Arctic ice at an alarming rate. In this chapter, we explore the dire consequences of this plastic peril. Studies have shown that up to 12,000 minuscule plastic pieces are found in every liter of sea ice, a shocking three times more than in the notorious Pacific garbage patch. Dr. Gunnar Gertz's research unveils a chilling fact: over recent decades, at least 1 trillion pieces of plastic have become entangled in the Arctic ice. Some of these particles are as tiny as 11 micrometers, posing a severe threat to marine life and potentially even human health. Beyond the immediate environmental impact, the repercussions of plastic pollution extend far and wide. Sea creatures mistake these plastic bits for food, leading to harm throughout the marine food chain and even infiltrating our own diets. The urgency to address this plastic peril is undeniable, as scientists and environmentalists rally to protect the fragile Arctic ecosystem and the global consequences of this growing crisis. Recently, scientists have ventured into the concealed domains of Antarctica's subglacial lakes, where life defies the harshest of conditions. These subglacial lakes, exemplified by the renowned Lake Vostok, serve as profound testaments to the tenacity of life beneath 3 kilometers of ice. In these extreme and enigmatic aquatic realms, astonishing discoveries have unveiled a thriving ecosystem inhabited by resilient microorganisms, colossal crabs, gigantic squid, and a myriad of other unique life forms. One captivating inhabitant of these subglacial lakes is the transparent ice fish, equipped with remarkable antifreeze glycoproteins, which enable them to navigate the frigid waters. What's truly astonishing is how these organisms challenge conventional notions of evolution, adapting to their lightless, nutrient-scarce environment by harnessing energy from unconventional sources like methane and ammonia. This chapter takes us on a mesmerizing journey, unraveling the mysteries of Antarctica's subglacial lakes. It sheds light on the pivotal role they play in expanding our understanding of life's adaptability and resilience. As researchers continue their exploration of these frozen worlds, we can anticipate even more astounding revelations, deepening our appreciation for the remarkable diversity of life that thrives in the most unexpected corners of our planet. Despite the relentless efforts of researchers, the ocean remains an enigmatic and spellbinding region, defying full comprehension and leaving scientists in perpetual awe. Thanks for watching another episode. While you're still here, make sure to click the video on your screen for more mind-blowing videos.